We are. This guy can't make up his mind on which Pearl Jam song he wants to listen to. It's bad. He has an unhealthy addiction to Pearl Jam.
I want to listen to them all.
Welcome to our Pearl Jam reaction. It's RG Fam Reacts here with another music reaction video. Today, we are doing Release by Pearl Jam.
Release?
He's like one of the biggest Pearl Jam fans ever.
No. Listen, I am a big Pearl Jam fan, okay? But there are way die-harder... When you go to these concerts and you see the people who have gone to like 5 gazillion concerts, I mean, I've only seen them like...
They're people for Pearl Jam like I am for Lil Uzi?
Yeah, I've only seen them like, no, way even... Way more.
Dude, I was in a 0.01% listeners on Spotify.
No. Yeah. So anyway, big fan, but there are definitely bigger fans. He wanted to do a song off of 10. He wanted to do Even Flow, which I really just cannot believe that you have not heard Even Flow. Just can't believe it.
I've like the only song that I recognize off this album is Alive.
Well, we listened to Black already. We actually reacted to Black.
Yeah.
You have to know Jeremy.
I don't even know if I know Jeremy.
You have to know Jeremy.
How's that go?
Jeremy spoke. No. Yes, you
do. Oh, yeah. I do.
Yeah,
know.
You have to know that song.
Jeremy's fire.
Yeah, you
That's
have
good.
To.
That's good on MTV Unplugged, too.
Yeah. You have to know Even Flow. Yeah. Even Flow was also on Unplugged.
That one song on MTV Unplugged, State of Love or something?
State of Love and Trust.
That song's amazing.
State of Love and Trust is amazing.
Love that,
that
song.
That is, it was originally on the album for the movie Singles.
Really?
The movie soundtrack.
That's their song though, right?
It's their song. Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a banger.
That is
great. Have you heard the rock version of it or just the acoustic?
No, just that.
Oh, rock version. Banger. Banger.
Okay.
But so we're trying, I said, let's just do one of the other songs, one of the non-popular songs, because they're all so good, and this is a classic album of all time. And talked about Oceans. Ocean to me is just beautiful. Porch is gritty. But Release to me is the most powerful. Especially you see him do Release live. Chills will go down your spine.
Yeah.
So, because you're going to go to a Pearl Jam concert.
Yeah.
And if they play Release, the little hairs
will
stand up on the back of your neck. It's just such a powerful song.
Well, let's listen to it then.
Let's check it out. All right. Release. Pearl Jam. Here we go. A minute and a half in, where are we at?
This is very like chill.
I could
definitely see myself like chilling out with this in the background.
Yes. You know? Mm-hmm.
I actually really enjoying it. I really like the instrumental. I always love Pearl Jam's. They're always great. They're great musicians.
They really are.
And Eddie Vedder's voice is amazing.
It truly is. This album's so amazing. All right. There you have it, Release by Pearl Jam. That's the final track on the album 10.
That's an amazing way to end that album.
Yeah.
That was very powerful. That's just him pouring his heart out.
Yeah.
Type.
So his story is he didn't know his dad.
Yep.
His dad, he met him once or twice,
mm-hmm.
but didn't know it was his dad
oh, really?
Until after he died.
Wow.
So,
okay.
There's a couple songs on this album
yeah.
that kind of touch, you know, on that. And then when you kind of know a little bit more about the story, you're like, oh.
Yeah. On the end of both of these chorus/verses type things.
Mm-hmm.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Seeing Release Me.
The lyrics.
Just his voice.
Yeah, the power. Yeah. He just opens up and he finally kind of lets it go.
He
and
does. I can definitely see. And chills down
your yeah, I mean, you just feel him just releasing.
Yep.
You know, they do that. They do this on the second album too. On the second album, Versus, the final song is it's called Indifference, which I actually even like more than this song.
Really,
Indifference might be my number one favorite Pearl Jam song. Same type of thing. They ended on this mm-hmm. just super super powerful song.
Yeah.
So.
Out of 10. This is definitely an 8.5.
Okay.
I really enjoyed it. I can definitely see, you know, driving in the middle of the night, having this blast.
Yes. And singing at the top of your lungs.
Yep.
Singing at the top of your lungs. Absolutely. It's a 9 for me. 9.5.
Out of 10?
9.5.
Have you ever given anything a 10? I don't think you have.
Well, it's because we don't generally do my all-time favorite songs.
It's true.
Because you already know most of those.
Yeah.
Because you had to grow up listening to them. But yeah, so love this song. It's powerful. It's amazing. We got to get you to do some of the other B-sides from 10. We're going to get you to do Oceans, Porch, Garden, Deep. They're all... It's a classic album. And when we say classic album, it means it's a classic.
We better hurry up and do it because I'm getting it on vinyl soon.
Ooh, boy. All right. Well, let us know what you think. What's your favorite Pearl Jam song, especially from 10? Which of the other kind of B-side songs should we do? Because he's never heard them, whether it be on this or on... let's stick to the first three albums because I don't think you've heard anything really off of...
Not a lot.
Off of Versus. And I don't think you've heard... You have heard Better Man.
Yeah, Better Man's amazing.
Better Man, that's from Vitalogy.
That's probably my favorite pro.
You ain't heard nothing yet, so.
Better Last Kiss.
So let's talk about in the comments. Let us know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe. We're almost to 1,000 Ks. Or 1,000 Ks.
1,000 Ks, I wish. 1,000
Ks, yeah, that'd be amazing.
That would be great.
Someday, maybe.
We're
at 1K almost subscribers on YouTube. Thank you to our patrons on Patreon. Link is below if you want to check that page out. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next episode. Bye.